Hello, welcome back, and happy Sunday if you're watching this on a Sunday. This week I was working on some beaded bead wheels for a quilt that I'm making, and I thought it might be kind of fun to show you how to make a really simple beaded bead wheel. If you're new to beading, this is a really great intro. A little bit later we'll talk about the different sizes of beads that you can use in this project, but I wanted to show you how to construct one first. You'll be able to find the pattern on my blog at this site here. It's a really simple project, so once you see it worked, you'll be able to experiment with your own beads that you might have at home, or you'll know what to shop for when you're out at the bead store, because that place can be crazy overwhelming. Okay, so here is a picture of the quilt block that I have put these beaded beads on. It's kind of a fun way to adorn the center of a pretty basic quilt block. And as you can see, this has been quilted and just ditched. There's no additional quilting on it. I think the bead does a good job of bringing your eye to the blocks. This bead wheel I made with size 8 seed beads, size 6 seed beads, which are the gold ones, and then the crystals, which are the ones in the center. Because the larger beads are two different shapes, you can actually see the original 10 large beads that I put in the center, which you can't always see. When you're using different beads of the same size, then you're going to get a different look depending on what you use, because they're different shapes. Some are more narrow and some are larger than others. So it just takes a little bit of experimentation, but I'll show you a couple of different bead setups as we go. But first thing you want to do is you want to pull about 18 inches off this bead thread. This is Nymo beading thread. Comes in lots of great colors. And it's really strong, so when you pull on it, it won't break. You can tug really hard. Now, threading a needle, let's see if I can get up here close, is the hardest part. This is a beading needle from John James. It's a size either a 10 or a 12, one of those two. Those are the only sizes I buy. And that's kind of the secret of threading a needle, is not holding it like this. Well, I see a lot of people holding their bead thread like this, and then they're trying hard to put the needle on, and all it's going to do is just bend this thing. So the secret is hold it really tight and squeeze it between your two fingers so you can barely see it. Can you kind of see that? And then put the eye of the needle over it, and that's the easiest way to bead the beading needle, because this is tiny. It has to be, because you're passing through these beads a lot of times with this thread. So the first thing you want to do, if you're looking at your pattern, it says string one large and one small bead 10 times, and we're going to leave a 4-inch tail. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to pick your first one. I'm going to pick these brown ones back here. These will be in the back on the underside of the bead. I'm going to pick up a large and a small. You can see the pattern just says large and small, which of course can mean all kinds of different things. So like I said, we will go through some different bead setups here in a little bit, but first I want to show you construction just so you can have a better idea of what it means when we talk about those. Oh my goodness, what's going on here? Okay, so string one large, one small, one large, one small, 10 times, so that you'll have 20 beads on there. Okay, so here I've got the 20 beads on. I've got a little tail here. And here's a hint on not getting your knot tied up in these beads. It says to take your tail and your string and just tie it into a square knot, which is just basically like the beginning knot to tie your shoe twice, okay? Don't bring the first part of that square knot all the way down to your beads quite yet, because inevitably a bead is gonna get locked up into the second time you knot it. I seriously, like 9 times out of 10 that happens to me. It drives me crazy. So even though I'm far up and I've just done a square knot, once you make that square, then pull real tight, and then you've got your ring, and there's no bead that's going to get locked up in that second part of your square knot. You can even tie a third just to really get it tight. Okay, and then the pattern says to take your needle and go through all of these beads once again. If you're really not great at threading your needle, you're not going to want to do what I'm about to tell you, which is fine. You can just take your needle and then just string it through all of these one time, and then you're ready to continue. But what I like to do, because I hate running out of thread, I'll actually restring the tail. See, that pinching of the end of the thread really helps. I'm really not even looking at it. I'm basically just threading it. You don't even need great eyes to do it. Okay, so I'm going to go through all of these beads once again just to strengthen the ring and keep it nice and tight as we go around. And you can see I'm going through 5 or 6 beads at a time. All right, so then at that point, I'm going to go ahead and just cut this tail off because it's knotted 3 times and I've run it around. So now it's out of my way, which is another bonus. The end of this thread is getting kind of shreddy, so I'm not even going to attempt to string it. Okay, so there's my ring, and then the next thing in the pattern, it says to exit out a small bead. So I take my string and I figure out where it's coming from. It's coming from this big bead, so in order to keep going in the same direction, I'm just going to go through a small, a big, and a small, and just exit out this small one. All right, and then it says to string 5 small beads. So we're gonna 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then skip 1 large bead and pass through a small bead. Okay, and that will kind of form into a V. Okay, so I'll do it one more time, and then I'll go all the way around, and then I'll meet you right back here. There's 5, skip a big bead, go into a little bead, pull it, and you'll just have these little V's that go all the way around your circle, okay? So go ahead and do that, and we'll come right back. Okay, so before we go on to the next step, I wanted to talk to you just a little bit about stepping up, finishing out the pattern, and then stepping out and exiting out the bead that it says, which can be a little confusing. So I'm on my last round. It's kind of like a knitting instruction. You've got to complete the entire pattern before you go on to the next row. And the end of this pattern says string 5, and the end says go through a small bead. And then it says exit out the third bead from the next 5 group done in this round. So before we can get to that, we've got to go into this bead and then travel up 1, 2, 3, and then we're ready for the next step. So it looks like this. Still completing your pattern. Now you could do this in one long string, but I'm gonna just do it in steps so you can kind of see. So completing the pattern is this, meaning I've gone through my next small bead here, and then exiting out the third bead of the next 5 group, which is this one. You just go up the little ladder here and you exit out that top bead. And just go really slowly when you're pulling your threads, because this tangly thing can happen, and if you're pulling too fast, if you're in too big of a hurry, you're going to get some frustrating tangles. So just go slow. Just enjoy the process. Okay, and so you've got these points. If it's not pointy on some of them, it's no big deal. It's just that the beads are kind of caught up on each other. But that will take care of itself in the next round, which says to add one small, this is on round five now we're at, one small bead, one large bead, and one small bead, and pass through the third bead of the next five group, which would be this one. So I'm going to use the red one, so these will be on the outside of my wheel. I'm going to go one small bead, one large bead, one small bead, and then you're going to pass through the third one in the next five bead group, okay? So that's what that looks like. Do another one, small, large, small, okay? And we're going to go through the top of that next V and do that all the way around. Once I go all the way around, I'm going to go all the way around again. So just through these, all of the top beads once again, and that will strengthen the wheel. And it looks like I'll probably run out of beading thread anyway, but that's okay. So I've gone all the way around twice, maybe even three times. I just keep kind of going it around because I'm about to run out of beading thread. And so I want to get this nice and woven in. The other thing you may notice is that depending on the size beads that you're using, you're going to have this, it's going to start curling up, which is just fine. You want to keep pulling tight. The beads will sort of loosen as you go, so don't worry about that. Just keep pulling tight. This is getting ready to fold itself over. The next round will kind of go in towards the center, and then we'll have another strand of beads, and then that's it. So it's all right if the sides are folding up. They're going to want to, just because you've got different size beads on. And then just to end a thread, I'm just going to keep running it through the beads. And now maybe since I've gone through the top a bunch, I'm going to run it in some of these side ones, maybe through the beginning again. And then try to go into an opposite direction. So I'm heading this way, but if I wanted to go up through these beads, oops, I really could at this point come back around and start weaving this thread back in on itself. I think that helps tighten everything up. And then once your bead thread gets super short, you can just clip it. Clip it off in the back. And the other thing you could do, and sometimes I do this, is I'll just leave it. And when I add my next string, which I'll do right now and show you, this one doesn't have to be quite as long. I'll go up where this bead is coming out and then tie a knot and then weave the longer tail in later. Okay, so now to start round seven, we need to come out the third bead again. So it's basically right here. So it's the top of that teepee that we did in round four, if you can see that. Let me pull this out. Just at the top of the V again. And then you're kind of working inside the circle. And then you are going to string five small beads again. This is why you need so many of the small beads. Three, four, 5. You're going to skip a small, a large, and a small, and go through the next bead in the 5 group, the 3rd bead of the next 5 group, which is that one. So you're creating another set of these little V's, little TP's. Okay, I'll do one more. String 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip a small, a big, and a small, and go into the top of the next 5 group set done in 4. Do that all the way around. Okay, so I've gone all the way around, and I have worked my last set into the top of the last teepee, and then I have traveled up these beads, and I am exiting out of that 3rd bead there. Can you see that? Let's see if I pull on the string. You can kind of see that. So now we're just going to put a crystal in between each bead. This is the best part because it goes really fast and it's really simple. So all we're going to do is we're exiting it out that bead. We're going to take a crystal and then run it through the top of the next teepee, that 3rd bead there. So that crystal will fit really nicely inside that B. Gosh, let's see if I can. All right, so do that all the way around. Pick up the next crystal, go through the next TP. If you can see how I'm holding the bead, I lift that little TP up with my thumb, and that way I've got it right there to just glide across, and that crystal is going to fit so nicely in that little V. Alright, so go all the way around. Okay, so here you have the finished bead. I went through this probably 3 times, and then I wove the original string back in, tied it with the back, and I cut it. Because I use different size large beads, I use these size 6 seed beads in this one, and I also used crystals, which are a little longer. The bead sort of wants to move around a little bit. So what you'll want to do, if that's the case, is you'll want to restring a thread, maybe 12 inches of thread, and then you're going to work maybe this round again and just go weave your needle even back down, up and down into the V's again. And what that does is not only does it strengthen your bead, but it will maintain the shape and the integrity of what you were trying to accomplish. It's really interesting the different bead combinations that you might use will give you a different shape at the end. So these were all size 8 seed beads were my small ones. And then the bigger ones, like I said, I did the same size, but 2 different shapes. So that's going to give you a product that's just a little different. So as long as you're just weaving, the more you weave in and out of all the beads in this structure, the less it will move around and the more you can shape it into a perfect round bead. Now that doesn't always happen. These little beads that I've made, I've used all delicas and all crystals. So that lays perfectly flat and those don't move around at all. You can tell the difference, the thickness difference between the two. And these were worked exactly the same way. No difference whatsoever. Here's another crystal. I'm using the word delica, and that may be a new term to you, but basically what that means is it's a size 11 seed bead. And when you go over to the big box stores, a lot of the times they'll have 11 seed beads, but they won't have delicas. You've got to go to a specific bead shop to get a nice variety of delicas. they look like this in compared to a size 11 seed bead that you might be able to get in like a multi-pack over at a craft store. So on the left-hand side here of this picture is a size 11 seed bead, and on the right is a delica or a cylinder bead. And the difference, as you can see, is that in the cylinder bead, the delicas, the hole is a lot bigger, so you can pass your needle and thread through several more times. And the other nice thing is that because they are perfect little cylinders, you can stack them. So if you wanted to do the peyote stitch or the brick stitch, use delicas over a regular size 12 seed bead, because you won't get that nice stacking effect. In this picture, here are the different size seed beads. Okay, so the one on the left is a size 6, the one in the middle is a size 8, and then the one on the end is a size 11. Not a delica, but a regular seed bead. And those you can get anywhere. The only thing is the size 8 seed beads, which I tend to use quite a bit, you can't find as readily available unless you go to a specific bead store. Or you could order through Shipwreck Beads or Fire Mountain Gems are my two favorite online bead resources. This next picture is what I would consider in the pattern a larger bead. So it's the original size 6 seed bead and a 4 millimeter crystal. So when the pattern says larger bead, this is where you'd want to go for the larger bead. And of course that depends on the smaller bead that you use next to it. So in the demo that we just did, we did these size beads, but with the size 8. These two, talking about size relation, the bigger beads were the size 8, which if you recall is the middle size of the seed bead, and the smaller size is a size 11, not a delica, but 11. So where you see the green, that's a size 11 seed bead, and the purple is size 8. These two beads were worked exactly the same, but on the right, all I did was I switched the color. So I did two colors of size 8 beads and two colors of size seed beads. And now that you've got these great bead wheels, what can you do with them? So I showed you already the one that's in the center of the quilt block. I love to do that. Those are really fun. These can also be used in art quilts. So like for these little ones, you could crochet a little stem and put these on the stem and kind of sew the stem down so that they sort of look like little, little flowers or whatever, botanical elements, we like to say. Here's another thing. Now this is an embroidery that I did, and I started with these bead wheels. Now these are beaded rivolis, which if you subscribe and you keep watching, at some point I will do another bead demo. I wanted to show you how to make a bezel for a rivoli, which are the real sparkly things in the center. You can see I've embroidered and then worked some additional beads on fabric, which I will definitely show you in a future demonstration. And the other one that I'll be showing you at some point is a Turkish embroidery, which is also known as oya, and it is a beaded trim that you can use for quilts or edges of clothing or whatever. So keep posted. I will be doing more bead demos in the future. But that's it for this week. Thank you so much for joining me again on Crosscraft Sundays in your PJs. I hope you get to stay in your PJs today. I know I'm going to. I'm off to do some needle felting, so we'll see you next week.